your size of your deposit, the grade of your deposit, the depth on surface, your commodity pricing, and all of those things to plan for a mine. But in an application process, even before you get to that, you need so many more things. Before you're even making money, you need to spend money on these applications. And all of those things fail in comparison to the aspects you need to consider before you start mining or prospecting. If you're in a protected area, and a protected area is a proclaimed nature reserve or heritage site or even a national park, graves, residential areas, but these must be in some gazette somewhere. It cannot just be someone saying my property is a nature reserve, or my property is a national park, or my property is a some sort of park, a local park or provincial park. It needs to be proclaimed in a gazette. Any area proclaimed in a gazette is a protected area if it's specified under the Protected Areas Act, and those are no-go areas for mining or prospecting. So even if you have the best ore body, if it's in that area, you will never touch it. So those are no, then you also get sensitive areas where the biodiversity, if you're in a sensitive biodiversity area, if you're in a wetland where your water, if you've got sensitive groundwater, if you've got existing infrastructure like roads or piping under the underground or ESCOM lines above you, all that makes a difference into where you can actually mine or where you can actually prospect. Back to the legislation. The minerals of South Africa do not belong to the person who owns the property. The minerals belong to the nation of South Africa, which the state is the custodian. The State Department responsible for minerals of South Africa is the Department of Mineral Resources. I think it's now the Department of Mineral Resources and Energy. So they are responsible to hand out rights. So you cannot go to a farmer or a landowner and say, okay, I want to prospect in your property. They don't own the land. They own the land. They do not own the minerals. They do not have any power to grant you that sort of right to the property. They cannot allow that. So you can't bypass a step and go to the landowner, because then you and the landowner is going against a national act, and that could result in jail time or a fine. Any act against a national act is a criminal offense. So not just minerals, also belong to the nation is air, water, biodiversity, and heritage amongst a few. All of these things need to be protected for everyone in the country. So when you go after minerals, you need to make sure mining or prospecting is not going to cause any harmful damage that's irreversible to the air, water, biodiversity, or heritage. So therefore, you also need permission in terms of those aspects, because now you're going after national assets. They are not individual assets, they belong to a nation. So it's not yours to decide. So even, as I said, if you buy the land, you still can't prospect on your own property. If you find a diamond on your own property, it's not yours. So that's the easiest way of saying it. So the greatest idea of, it's not nationalized, but making this stuff into part of national acts is that the environment should be protected for the current generation and for future generations. But protection does not mean it cannot be touched. It just means taking care of it in a sustainable manner where you can be there for future generations. So back to the point is, you know, some of this stuff don't talk about geology. Some of this stuff talk about geology. So does a geologist need to know this, or do you need a consultant for this work?